Slow poker.
I have a career and a family, but also play poker, which doesn't leave me much time, so let's get to it. It's been a minute since the last normal slow poker episode. There was that absurd live stream against people with too much disposable income, after which I zigzagged America as a poker fugitive slash fake senior citizen, which led to a $25,000 tournament that I had zero business playing. All of that was a blast, but let's get back to my roots. And if you recall, in my last normal episode, I met a special someone. Lady. Hey, I had a really nice time last hand. Pocket threes. I think I'm in love with you. So we take our honeymoon in the most romantic city on earth, Round Rock, Texas. Our first stop in town is a charming little hideaway called The Lodge, owned by three fellow poker content creators, each with their own special claim to fame, be it low favorability rating, a rare, lethal sleeve allergy, please donate today, or just generally being a gutless piece of shit. But before we get to those three, let's get with these threes and find out how poker is played deep in the heart of Round Rock. We start our day in the hijack, raise to 15, and get called by the button and that guy. All of you have played with that guy. Some of you may be that guy. You'll see what I mean. And while this flop isn't great for me and my three and my three, we should bet range, because that's kind of this like sweet thing we used to always do when we first met. But since we just landed in Texas and haven't really gotten our bearings, we take the passive route, which is dumb. If these two whiffed, it's our pot right now. Instead, flop, turn, and river is a check baby, 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. But at least we get our first glimpse of Texas range. And it's as advertised. What happened to us, Pocket Threes? One day we're flopping quads together, and now I have to share you with 10-6 and 4-deuce? Oh, don't do that. Don't give me the shoulda continuation bet look. I get it, alright? We all make mistakes.
Oh, you know what that sound means. It's time for everyone's favorite game.
Poorly played poker.
Let's meet today's contestant, Slow Poker. Are you ready to play, Slow?
Apparently not, but I'll try.
Let's play the game. In round one, we're giving you pocket jacks. You don't notice when that guy limps, so you raise to only 15, which button calls, and that guy limp calls. And after this flop, that guy leads out for almost twice the pot. Do you A, call, B, raise, or C, fold?
Oh, wow. So a limp caller could have anything, and he did have 10-6 in that first hand, so I guess he could have that here too, and I don't see how he's betting so big into two people with, you know, something as weak as a top pair, some kicker. And the button could be strong, so I want to go with C, fold.
Oh, I'm sorry, that's incorrect. Obviously. And while at first you feel much better about your fold, when button raises to 200 and that guy calls, you head right back to disgust after they check it down and you see the bad news. That has to sting. But let's see what Slow Poker's won. Oh, nothing. He's lost money. And his self-respect. Let's move on to round two, where you've got tens. The straddle may be on, but you're not sure, and that guy raises far too large in $30. Folds to you on the button, do you A, call, B, raise, or C, fold?
Oh, well, I'm not gonna fold. But I am on the fence, because usually a preflop overbet screams weakness, and this guy is not very good, so I'm inclined to raise large here. But, you know, I could just flat and see a flop, so yeah, I'm gonna say A, call.
Oh, wrong again! That he's a bad player makes it even more of a no-brainer spot to raise. And while this flop seems to bail you out, and after that guy checks, you bet he tank calls, and after this turn he checks, you bet he Hollywood calls again, and after this river he leads for pretty small, and you're livid that he hit his gut shot draw as you fold. Turns out that's all irrelevant, since he had you beat the whole time and was just slow playing the nuts, and he could have gotten far more value from you with a check raise on any street. How embarrassing for both of you. But let's see what Slow Poker's won. Oh, again, nothing. Just losses. Cash and dignity. And now a word from our sponsor.
Do you want to make smarter choices in sports betting? Then try Odds Jam. Odds Jam is plus EV. Unlike slow poker.
Hey.
Head to oddsjam.com and use promo SLOW20 for 20% off your subscription for life. Use that code to support slow poker in his shameful, demoralizing time of need.
It's not that bad.
Yes. Yes, it is.
It's the final round, and you've got Ace King of Spades. UTG raises, three players flat, and now it's your turn. Do you A, call, B, raise, or C, fold?
Well, I've certainly learned my lesson. A, call.
Seriously, bro? The answer was raise. This is the perfect squeeze opportunity. All that dead money, three flat callers, you have to raise.
I know, I'm sorry, I'm nervous. My whole family's here. Hey guys.
Well, not to be results oriented, but you're gonna wish you'd raised, because after this flop checks around, you turn the nuts, check call the big turn bet, and then your attempt at a river trap fails miserably. The fish didn't take the bait, huh? It's 'cause he's not the fish. Someone else is the fish. You're the fish. But let's see what he's won. The bare minimum. That's progress. But not really. You've set poker back several years. Well, that's it for today's show. Join us next time on...
Poorly Played Poker.
Okay, time to reset. I've got kings. Raise to 20. That guy raises to 50. I raise to 190. He shoves. I snap. He asks twice. I say nope. And while getting kings in preflop is certainly a cerebral, highly advanced move, it doesn't absolve me from my earlier garbage play against that guy. Like, so what if I find God on my deathbed? Doesn't make all that murder cool. Still, it does feel nice to win the war after showing up to all those battles with a plastic butter knife. Oh, and you may ask, why decline to run it twice? Never been a fan. You make a decision and live with the results. It's not like you can run it twice in real life. Two roads diverged in a wood. I'ma take both. I've got queens, and after a UTG raise to 20 and a whopping three callers, I kinda wanna see a flop, so I flat from the small blind. Okay, alright, I raise to 150. They all fold except the lowjack short stack, who shoves, and I call. And while I do win the pot, I don't win hearts and minds.
Do you remember the color of the nines?
I know. Any and all backlash is absolutely deserved. Trust me, I feel awful. Don't kick a man when he's chipless. The thing is, I'm here to film a poker show, and I really want the details to be accurate, and no. STFU, slow. There's no excuse. Ah, but wait, we're not done here. Because after sprinting over to apologize to the lowjack, and BT Dubs, he's a total gentleman about it, I return to the table to some news. Every last player tells me, spades and clubs.
You gotta be kidding me!
Great, so the answer was readily available, and I made a fool of myself for nothing. On the bright side, at least you now have perfect details, of which you probably couldn't care less.
Everything I do it for you.
And now, the new mini-series. You know, I can play shit hands too. I've got Jack 10 offsuit, and after hijack raises to 10, I call, and big blind calls, the flop's got potential. Big blind and hijack check, and I consider bluffing with my two overs and my gutshot draw, but there's something kinda sus about the way the big blind checked, so I'll take a free turn card. But first, I look up on the wall and see a poster of Bart Hansen. Ready, Bart? Let it rip.
The river's a nine! Oh!
Okay, I mean, it's the turn, Bart, but, you know, close enough. Big blind leads for 20, and given all the two pairs and sets out there, or if he's just got a 10 and thinks we're chopping, I make it 75. But big blind doesn't take too long before open folding the flopped bad straight. You've gotta be kidding me. Sure, there's a four-liner out there, but most players just see one straight, any straight, and are all, shove! Of all the gin cards in all the world, I gotta hit that one when I'm up against a guy who actually, like, you know, thinks through stuff.
Really?
I've got King Deuce of Hearts, and after a hijack and button limp, I do expressly what Lee Jones discourages in his piece on overlimping from the small blind with a marginal hand. But Lee's example is Jack Rag. This is King Rag. That That's a world of difference. I mean, just look at this guy. My man's got a knife in his head and is all, what, this? Yeah, so just call me Don Knotts, because incredibly, I'm a limpet. On this flop, I lead for 15 and hijack calls. And after this turn gives me this hand, I have this flashback of when I was 22 and showed up late to a game at Fenway and saw these white guys with painted faces holding up these. And I was like, God, I know Red Sox fans can skew awful, but these two are just going to be this openly racist. And then I realize, oh, three strikeouts. Eesh. Sorry, Red Sox fans. I mean, a lot of you are racist, but anyway, I bet 30 and he calls again. And on this river, I bet 80 and he snaps it off. Hijack flashes the nine of spades. So, king nine? A non-believer with pocket nines? I don't know. But this I do know. Based on one data point alone, it's now confirmed. Acclaimed poker author Lee Jones doesn't know dick. I've got the penultinut low, and because this hand in this room holds a special place in my heart...
Well, gentlemen, when the hits the fan, some play aces and some play 4-3.
I raise to 15, get 3-bet to 60, and I consider just ripping it in on account of Texas preflop charts, but tight old habits die hard. You know, y'all Texans keep whining that I should loosen up, and here I loosen up, and then look what happens. This is your fault!
Who taught you how to do this stuff?
You, all right? I learned it by watching you.
Were you happy with your experience at the lodge? Please say yes. It's a pretty nice place. Friendly staff, reasonable fees, the beigest felt in town. Like, no contest. I spent some quality time with the owners. Doug Polk seemed all right. I mean, say what you will about him, he's a pretty divisive figure. But when we met, he said, look, you've got far fewer subscribers than I do. So, let me do this. To get the word out, I'll run slow poker episodes on all the TVs here all week. And in return, just sign this little agreement prohibiting you from suing me for slander when I run my slow poker hit piece. Snap call.
What's up, guys? Doug Polk here. Breaking news. Slow poker illegally hacked the TVs at my club, so you should immediately stop watching everything he makes. Because he's a wanted criminal. You know, I could be more even-handed when I run these mud-smearing videos. Sometimes I kind of get loosey-goosey with the facts. And given my clout, what I say does have an outsized impact, not just on clicks, but on careers, and even on people's mental health. Huh. You know what? I'm gonna do it. Starting now, Doug Polk is fair and balanced. Next up, Charlie Carroll has long hair and most men have short hair, so he stole the hair from someone he murdered.
Next, there's owner number two, Andrew Neeme, who, if you recall, is quite the slow fanboy.
So Andrew, I know you're watching, because you always do, and always comment with a ton of heart emojis, and it's kind of overkill, but...
Andrew suggests that we play something called the stand-up game, where everyone stands up, and when you win a hand, you sit down. I know that already that sounds thrilling, but there's more. The last man standing has to pay everyone, like 50 bucks each or something. Here's a candid shot of me and others as we get underway, including the, as per usual, scared shitless Brad Owen, photography by Andrew Neeme, who tells everyone, and I quote, I just wanted a picture of the whole group. Slow poker just happens to be centered in the shot. I definitely won't be printing an oversized poster of this for my bedroom ceiling. Andrew, God, let it go, man. So at this point, two or three winners have already taken a seat and are safe. And I've already folded ace-jack offsuit facing a 3-bet in front of me, so I'm getting a wee bit antsy, which leads to this. The straddle is on, and it folds to me in the hijack with ace-8 offsuit. Now, normally, these bad boys go straight into the muck, but the stand-up game? It does something to a man. His range widens. He hears voices. In this case, the siren song of a chair cushion. So I raise to 30. The cutoff calls. Then we all grab popcorn and watch the assassination of these two cards by the coward Bradley Owen, and the straddle defends. And normally, I wouldn't love this flop, but middle pair and spades? That's all I need for my butt to whisper, see you soon, chair. Straddle checks, I bet 40, cutoff folds, straddle calls, and after a blank turn, a straddle check, and a buck 25 out of me, he snap folds, and I snap sit. Wow, this stand-up game really upends the way I think about poker. I should always fight more for pots, play with more urgency, just pretend that I'll get penalized for playing like a Brad Owen-style sissy pants. Huh. Brad, what do you think?
I like folding.
I've got kings. After a UTG limp, I raise to 25, small blind calls, and limper back raises to 115. All right, it's always tough to know what to make of a limp raise. It's almost always a good hand, but is it pocket aces good? Sometimes. In fact, the memory that immediately comes to mind is one from a video made by the guy sitting 10 feet away, who will just not stop looking at me. Neeme, enough already. But yeah, in one of his videos, Neeme raises with kings over a UTG limp, faces a 3-bet and a limp 4-bet, and ends up folding kings preflop, which, according to legend, has been done by others.
I folded kings!
And in both cases, aces. But heads up, I do have some options. Do I raise and maybe fold to a jam? Do I raise, call a jam, and if it's aces, YOLO? Given the Neeme video is front of mind, I take a somewhat unorthodox approach and just call. I guess to set mine? I'm not sure about this one. What I am sure about is there's only one card I don't want to see on the flop, and that's But UTG checks. Obviously the flop is dry, so if he's got top set, he might not feel compelled to bet. With some trepidation, I check back. After this turn, he bets a puny 55, and I suppose he could be squeezing just a few more drops out of me, where he's really not worried about much, but I call. And after this river, and a check by him? I'm confused. Do I bet here for thin value? But what worse hand is calling? This is weird. I feel like I'm gonna regret this, but check? Well, that was something. But maybe I got more value than I would have re-raising preflop, provoking a fold, and missing out on his turn stab. I'm not sure, but dude, stop. We're both married to women. Yes, I already answered that. Sure, if it'll shut you up, fine. Run it. I've got the Skylar Hawker, and facing a raise from the third owner, aforementioned uber-wuss Brad Owen, I 3-bet and give him one of these. He sh**s his diaper and folds.
Brad, that's weak.
And would you look at that? He folded fours, and he'd have flopped quads. What a baby. I've got nines, raise to 20. I would folds. Ooh, shocker. And button raises to 70, and I call.
Are you having flop problems?
Don't feel bad for me, son. I've got 99 problems, but this flop ain't one. I check in flow, and as I silently debate whether to check raise or smooth call button's inevitable continuation bet, he checks back. Interesting. After this turn, I consider betting to start building a pot and maybe get a crying call from non-believing ace high or pocket jacks or tens or a DOA backdoor flush draw. According to Red Chip Poker, however, solvers advise more checks here than bets. So with some reluctance, I check again and button checks back. On this river, I gotta eke out some value and I bet what's probably far too high in 90. He's just gonna fold. But he's not. He's raising to 425? Is he now? Okay, first, yes, I know what every poker player is thinking.
What the hell are you waiting for?
Granted, but let me just think this through. In this configuration, I put him on a pretty narrow range of hands. I'm gonna rule out these, because he's folding or maybe side calling with those, and he would have c-bet flop with these. And he's a smart player, so I do not see him overvaluing this. And just to be far too thorough, there's no queen-nine suited out there, and no straight flush. Oh, I checked. So what's left? I can't even imagine what... Oh, no. Stop it. This is not quads. It's not, right? Okay, I know it's absurd, but it's honestly the only story that makes sense. So what do I do? Well, I have three options. Okay, I'm not gonna fold. If it's quads, it's quads. But is there ever a world where I just call? But if I'm calling, why not shove? It's kind of a fascinating philosophical riddle where there really shouldn't be an option B. But if I can only land on quads, why is my impulse not A, but C? God, I wish I could bounce these ideas off someone.
Would you like to use a lifeline?
Oh, sure. There's poker professor Bart Hansen. What do you think, Bart? Never mind, you're preoccupied. Oh, there's main event runner-up Tony Miles, who cut his poker teeth in my hometown of Jacksonville, Florida. Tony?
Nine.
Wow, another bluff shove!
Oh, you're busy punting. Okay, twist my arm. Brad Owen, sage advice? Shut up! I don't care what you would've done. I want to take action now! What a waste of space. All right, you know what? Even if the only hand that makes sense to me is quads, if he's got it, fine. It'll be a story. An expensive story.
I'm all in.
You got quads?
Oh, I see now. That makes more sense. I probably shouldn't have had pocket eights in my blind spot. Sidebar, poker gods? Come on, that river? Just gross. Well, I guess my turn check was a stroke of genius, right? Sure, let's go with genius. Anyway, thanks, Jay-Z, for all the assists. You're irreplaceable. Owen Button, let me just direct traffic here. To the left, all those chips right there. Pass them here, to the left. And that'll do it for episode 22 of Slow Poker. Please like, subscribe, comment below, and... Oh, sorry, I gotta take this.
Slow Poker, man, what's your problem with me?
Hey, Brad, I'm sorry, something real important came up. I gotta run.
Until next time, this has been
Slow Poker.